exercise 22-12. This is a week about variable and absorption costing to discover a different way to take the same information, rearrange it in a way that would allow us to have a useful tool for management purposes. Let me say that at this point in the semester, at this point in your accounting maturity, I would like for you to be less dependent on examples. Way back in chapters 1, 2, 3, and 4, when you started with a homework problem or a solution of some sort, I would say, find an example in the book and do it like it. We were very example-driven. And that's still true to a certain extent. But one of the things that we ought to know this week is that there's more than one way to write down stuff. There's kind of two sides of that. We're learning a whole new approach here in the variable cost of the income statement. But I want to give you some freedom that it doesn't always have to look like a teacher's manual. It doesn't always have to look like a book. It can take on a different format and still be correct. Okay? I want to say at the beginning of this, too, that there's a rounding issue in this exercise. I'm not sure which way to do it. I found three solutions of this, three attempts in my file folder, three sets of transparencies of different rounding techniques here. And I didn't label them well from the last time I used them, and I don't recall which one works out best. I do not want you to miss this message, this lesson, because of rounding. This is not about rounding. We do this approaching it from two different ways, and usually when we do that, we call it proof. And I'm afraid that we won't prove this, and you'll think that it's flawed, and the flaw is rounding. It's not in the theory here, the concept. So please don't allow rounding to be an obstacle for you. I need your help with calculations. If you've got a calculator and you want to get it out and participate and help me out, that'd be nice too. And we're going to do more than 22-12 requires. I'm going to embellish this a bit. Surprise, surprise. Read with me. T equipment company manufactures and distributes industrial air compressors, with the emphasis being on industrial. The following costs are available for the year ended December 31st. The company has no beginning inventory. They produced 1,500 units in the current year and sold 1,300. Ending inventory was how many units? Everybody that knows said? Not enough people said. 200 units. The unit sales price was $4,500. Whew. I was thinking I might have one of these in my garage. But it said industrial air compressor. And I'm not spending $4,500 for one. Sorry. There's not one in my garage after all. Costs and expenses are listed there. I'm going to ask you questions about that list in just a moment. The instructions say, compute the manufacturing cost of one unit using variable costing and prepare an income statement using variable costing. Well, let's do what they ask us to do in A, compute the manufacturing cost of one unit variable costing. I'm wondering if you would be willing to do it without my help, or you would be willing to do it with my prodding. If you would be willing to do it all alone, or if you would be willing to be a participant, and many people contributed to this to help me get to the right answer. Name a cost, say an amount that should be included in this answer. Compute the manufacturing cost of one unit of product using variable costing. Jeff, will you start us out?
Direct labor for 1,000.
Why did you, your eyes got a little off. Direct labor is not 1,000.
Oh no, 1,500.
So why did you skip one?
Well, I didn't mean to.
Could we start at the top of the list and work down?
Yes, direct materials.
Direct materials for 1,000. Thank you very much. Is a variable cost we established in Monday's lecture. Yes or no, Jeff?
Yes.
You want on the hook or off the hook?
Off the hook.
Name me a cost that should be included in this answer, Jeff.
direct labor.
How much?
$1,500.
Direct labor of $1,500 should be included here. How y'all doing? Y'all with Jeff and me? On the hook or off the hook, Jeff?
On.
Go.
Variable manufacturing overhead.
Variable manufacturing overhead was?
$300.
$300. Keep going, Jeff.
And is that that's it?
How about variable selling administrative expenses?
That doesn't come until later, right?
That's correct. A long time ago, we started differentiating between cost and expenses. They have some similarities. Costs are things that go into the product that we're producing. Expenses are things that happen after that or unrelated to that. And here they are, mentioned again. Here they will be next week. It's funny that this week we split them apart, and next week we kind of lump them together. Just depends on what we're doing. So we were asked to find the variable cost of one unit. Is there any other information there, Jeff, that we should include? You want a hint?
Manufacturer's overhead?
Yeah. The variable you've already told me about. What about the fixed?
1,400,000.
Now, does that seem comparable? Level playing field? Comparing apples and oranges? How else could I describe this? Tucker?
You say the answer for that?
Would you like to say the answer to that?
Yeah. Zero.
Jeff?
$933.33.
$933.33, you determined how?
By dividing the 1.4 million. By the units produced.
Well, at least it would be on a per unit basis. The 1.4 million just seems way out of whack. This is the cost of one unit. I know they're industrial air compressors, but to lump 1.4 million all with that one makes it. Right, Jeff?
Mm-hmm.
So if you divided the 1.4 million by. What'd you divide by?
$1,500.
The 1,500 units you produced. Then those fixed costs would be allocated over the production at $933.33 each. Right, Jeff?
Right.
Right, Tucker?
Right.
Right, Whit?
I'm not sure.
Tucker?
I'm thinking this is variable, so it's going to be zero for fixed manufacturing overhead.
Why would I write this out here if there weren't some corresponding number
next to it? Because next time, for absorption costing, we're going to have a number. So.
Fixed cost, Sam? How much? Aren't you glad you came to class today to find out? Toby?
I think zero for comparison's sake.
Shane?
Zero.
Jeff? Help me out here. Aaron? Dustin?
Going 933.
Jeff?
I like 933 too. But I don't know.
Now that was a dirty trick. Jeff? Why is this zero?
So it
says fixed. Yeah. Say it the other way.
Because it's not variable.
Thank you. That's a better answer, don't you think?
Yeah.
Because it's not variable. We were specifically asked to find the variable cost of one unit. And I just did my dead level best to trick you and succeeded with some of you. All these other things were variable. Fixed cost has nothing to do with this. I wanted to make the point even more obvious than it was that fixed costs shouldn't be a part of this decision. Are you with me or not? This sum is Jeff. Jeff?
$2,800.
$2,800. The book said find the cost of one unit using variable costing, it cost us $2,800 to produce one unit. And we sell that unit for $4,500. I think the book should have asked, perhaps A2 should have said, compute the manufacturing cost of one unit using absorption costs. Tucker, help me out.
So direct materials would be 1,000.
And?
Direct labor, 1,500.
This is sounding familiar. Is this deja vu?
Yeah.
Must I write all that again, Tucker?
Yeah.
Could I get there a little teeny faster?
Just copy it down.
Copy and paste?
Yeah. Right.
Could I start with 2,800?
No. Mm-hmm. You couldn't.
Could I start with 2,800, Nick? No. Aren't all these costs going to be part of it? Absorption costing? Yes or no? Aaron? I can't believe I'm losing you on this.
Oh, okay.
Come on. Must I repeat all of these? Can't I just start where we left off and edit it a little bit? If you're going to copy and paste the whole thing. All of these costs are part of absorption costing, too. Let's start with the 2,800. Okay, Tucker? Is that the only cost I incur? Talk to me, Tucker.
Fixed manufacturing overhead.
Now we're going to fill in something for this. Fixed cost would be? It's okay. Do you remember the discussion?
It was like $9,333.
It was $933.33. It was total fixed cost, $1.4 million. Y'all see where I see that? Manufacturing overhead? Divided by the number of units we produced. It was, there it is, I showed my work, of 1.4 million divided by 1,500 units produced, Jeff said came out to be $933, I'm going to say, and 33 cents. I'm going on a limb here hoping that it'll come out better if we don't round off, and we're rounding there. So this sum is
373.
Toby?
373.
It cost us $3,733 to produce one unit of absorption costing, all the cost we incur. It's one lesson all week long. It's the difference in fixed and variable cost, how they behave and how we treat them because of the way they behave. So, given that, B says, prepare an income statement using variable costing. Is variable costing the new way or the old way?
New way.
I would like for us to review the old way before we do the new way. So I'm going to insert B1 before what the authors ask us to do. I'm going to ask that we review and prepare us an absorption costing income statement first. Will you help me? Where should we begin? Brandy. Sales. Christian. Didn't hear you. I see her lips moving. Is she talking? Where do we begin on an income statement? Let's put a good heading on it. And right after the good heading, we want to describe the revenue that we earned. If you're willing to do this for me, and everybody in the room should be, would you raise your hand and talk to me right this minute? We earned revenue of come on. Aaron?
$5,850,000.
You determined how?
1,300 units by 35
1,300 units were sold at $4,500 each. Yes? Comes out to be $5.85 million. And from sales, we need to subtract something. Could you name it? At least, and perhaps tell me how to get it. Toby?
Is it cost of goods manufactured?
For plain hot and cold, you're really warm. I'm looking for what, Toby?
You're looking for what?
What am I looking for to deduct from revenue to finish this income statement? I'm giving you another chance. If I were Bob Barker and this were the Price is Right, what's that new guy's name? The one with the big glasses, Drew Carey. Drew, say his name? If I had the price of the car up here and we just changed one digit, you'd win the car, ding, 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 ding. Cost of goods sold. I'm looking for cost of goods sold, and I want to draw a comparison. At the beginning of the day, I said, you're too concentrated on following somebody else's example, and you're too methodical, and I need you to think on your own some. I'm going to give you a choice. Yes, it's all about format this week, but I'm going to show you something as a sub-lesson to this new format we're talking about. I need somebody that has a stopwatch and knows how to work it. Alexis, can I depend on you?
Yeah.
What we're going to do in a minute when I tell you to start is we're going to calculate cost of goods sold. And then we're going to stop, write down that number for comparison's sake, and we're going to start all over on this income statement as if we had never worked it. And we're going to do cost of goods sold a different way and see how the time compares. Okay, Alexis?
Okay.
So how about starting it right this minute? And somebody help me with how do I find cost of goods sold? Where do I begin? If you know where to begin, hold up your hand and let's talk. The clock is ticking. Toby, you just responded to me so well, I'm going to get me a new volunteer. Sam, we should start with the beginning inventory. The beginning inventory in this problem, Sam, is
zero.
Now, I'm not going to write it down because it seems silly to write down zero. Remember that slide I had on the screen a minute ago tricking you when the answer was zero? There was really no need to put that up there except to make a point. So we need to talk about it because in life there will be a beginning inventory. In your homework for today, there was a beginning inventory part of the time. To beginning inventory, we need to add something. May I have a volunteer to tell me what that is? Brandy?
Variable cost of goods sold.
No. I'm doing the absorption costing income statement. I'm looking for cost of goods sold. I want to know where to go with this. Could you help me, TJ? I need to know the cost of the ones I manufactured. Can you help me find that number?
I want to say 1,500.
I produced 1,500 is correct. What price was the price that we spent? In the first part of this exercise, we determined the variable cost to be 2,800, I think. Was that the number I remembered correctly? Yes or no?
Yes.
And we determined the fixed cost to be another
933.33,
yes or no?
Yes.
Oh, I wanted it to look better than that. The total cost, absorption costing wise, was 3733 was the cost of one unit that we produced. TJ, is that true? And you said we ought to multiply that by 1,500 units. Have you done it for me? Has anybody?
Yes.
Toby?
599,995.
See, here's where I go off on a limb, because I'm going to call that 5.6 million. Did you get 95 cents on the end?
$5.
$5?
Yeah.
The lesson ought to be round consistently and ought to work, and I got three solutions and maybe I picked the wrong one. Would you not miss the point about the exercise because I chose to round differently? Because it was so many units, because it was so many dollars, it should have been 5.6 million.
So many millions.
Just let me know when you want to stop the time.
Yeah.
We're still in the process. Mm-hmm. Do we know cost of goods sold yet? We don't. So keep running. So, is it okay to deduct the cost of 1,500 units produced from the revenue earned from selling 1,300 of them, class? Big Hardy? When you shake your head, I can't hear you. Is it okay to deduct the cost of 1,500 units from 1,300 units of revenue, yes or no?
No.
Can we get there from here? I need a volunteer. How can I get where I need to be right this minute? Toby?
We calculate ending inventory.
Ending inventory consisted of how many units, Toby?
200.
Ending inventory of 200 units should be valued at what price, Toby?
3733.33
times 200 units in ending inventory, Toby, is?
746.67.
I rounded in here's whole dollar. I'm not rounding consistently. I hope this works out. This problem's not about rounding. It's about variable absorption cost. The cost of 1,500 units minus the cost of 200 units yields the cost of 1,300 units. This minus this is, I need a new volunteer to tell me this number. Raise your hand so I know to listen to you. Nick?
4,853,333.
I got $4,853,333. We could have gone with 33 cents pretty easily, couldn't we? Could you stop the stopwatch, please? We have now determined cost of goods sold. How long did it take us to find cost of goods sold, Alexis?
4 minutes and 40 seconds.
Now, it's hard to play this part of the game because it happened and I'm asking you to pretend it didn't happen. I don't want you to start the timer yet, but I want to recreate the scene of the crime as if we didn't experience what we just experienced. What if this were the beginning of the lesson? What if I said, let's do us an income statement? What if I said, where would you start on an income statement? And the answer was, we'd put a good heading on it. And right after the good heading, we'd subtract sales. And sales, we already know to be 5.85 million. Is it okay if I just fast forward the class a little bit to make sure that we finish and borrow that number? Is that okay with everybody? Okay. A minute ago, I said we're going to find cost of goods sold, and it was right after that that we started the stopwatch. So now I'm going to say we're going to find cost of goods sold, and we're going to start the stopwatch. Some people like to know all the details. Some people don't care about format. They just care about knowing the information. How many units of revenue did I report here? Say it. How many units of cost should I deduct against that? So help me find 1,300 units of cost. Each unit cost me, over there on that chalkboard it says 3733. Yes or no? Could you multiply this out for me real quickly? 1,300 units times 3733.33 is, who's got me this number on the calculator right this minute, Aaron?
1,670,000.
Okay,
1,679,985.
99985?
Yeah,
then
erase that.
Erase that through. Aaron, let's take one more shot.
1,679,985.
Sounds like one of Toby's answers. I think this might need to be rounded up.
It's
for what?
It's
wrong.
It's wrong. Is this not even close?
Not even close.
It's okay. Is it okay to make a mistake?
Yeah.
Yeah, it is. It's okay. You got me a number, Michelle? 48,000 doesn't seem reasonable. I'm asking for 1,300 times $3733.33 per unit. May I have a hand up somebody who's willing to give me this number. Nick?
4,853,329.
Yes. It's pretty close to that number over there, isn't it? It's just rounded. Could you stop the stopwatch? Now, y'all know this wasn't a fair test, don't you? Because we had some trouble getting to this point. Yes or no? Alexis, what's on the stopwatch at this minute?
225.
225 is way overstated. It didn't take us that long. Now, y'all think I got a different number, and I think I got the same number. This is a perfectly acceptable way to do this. This is 1,300 units of revenue minus 1,300 units of cost. This is gross profit, subtract some expenses, get your net income, present that to some user, and they'd be satisfied with your answer. It'd be a right answer. It's just rounding. They cost it to be different. We did the 33 cents on that and got this, yes or no? Did y'all really do the 33 cents? Somebody multiply it out and just do 1,300 times 3733 and don't put the 33 cents on it. Tell me what you got. Hurry, I don't have all that.
It's 485,2900.
485,2900. So it's further on. The problem's flawed, but it's the lesson. You can do it this way and show your work and subtract out the ending inventory from all the cost you incurred, or you can just go straight to the answer and accomplish matching and offset 1,300 units of revenue with 1,300 units of cost. The difference here is not because of some conceptual thing, it's because of rounding. That'd be a perfectly acceptable way to do it if you wanted to. The one we started. I know cost of goods sold would be this number. Would you subtract cost of goods sold from sales? While you're subtracting it, would you blurt out loud the name of this subtotal, quickly? The name of this is?
Gross profit.
We're asked to find gross profit. When you have me that number, would you raise your hand and tell me? Alexis? 996,667 should be gross profit. And from gross profit, we want to subtract some things. If you're willing to name those things that we need to subtract, hold up your hand so I'll know to listen to you. What are we going to subtract from gross profit? Toby?
Selling and administrative expenses.
Selling and administrative expenses were how much, Toby?
100,000.
Didn't hear you, sorry.
100,000.
100,000 you found where? Those are the fixed ones? Were they the only ones?
No, they're not the only ones.
But they certainly need to be included here, don't they?
That's right. So we should start with variable first.
Doesn't matter. No?
So it's 100,070.
All right. 100,000 is going to be the fixed. And 70. 100,070.
That's right.
Ooh, I don't think so. Yeah. That's the same problem that Jeff had early in this exercise.
That's
when.
Pretty good.
When I'm talking, don't talk. When we tried to compare apples and oranges, or an uneven playing field, or something like that. One of those numbers is per unit, and one of those numbers is in total, and we need to get them both in the same ballpark to be able to talk about it. Yeah. I think Toby's got something he'd like to say.
Yeah, I get it.
Got it.
You want it?
Yeah.
Okay. So variable cost for selling an administrative expense is 70 times 1,300.
1,300 times 70 is?
91,000.
In variable cost,
that's right.
100,000 in fixed cost. I probably wouldn't show these two numbers separately. It's just this week we're doing this. Here's $191,000 of selling administrative expenses. What are you going to do with that number, Toby?
Subtract.
Gross profit minus this number is going to give us net income. Net income is some different person than Toby. What are y'all doing? Shane? One more time, Shane.
$805,667.
$805,667 is net income on an absorption costing basis. At the beginning of this, we should have predicted whether this number was going to be larger or smaller than variable. I wish we had done it at the beginning. We can still do it now. We don't know what variable is going to be. Let's predict. It has to do with whether or not inventory changed. Inventory went from zero to 200 units. Inventory increased. If inventory changes at all, increase or decrease, variable absorption will give you different answers. Now, your job right this minute is to answer the question, what will the difference be? I don't mean literally. They won't give you the same answer. Which one's going to be larger? Which one's going to be smaller? You can just pick one of those if inventory increases. Inventory increase from 0 to 200 units. Is absorption going to be larger than variable or variable larger than absorption? If you know, tell me and be willing to tell me why. Hurry. We got to do this faster.
Are you asking for net income or cost?
I'm asking for this net income figure. Net income will be different under variable absorption costing when inventory changes. This is my last time to appeal for this. I'm watching the clock. Will you address this for me or not? Tucker, you want me to call on you?
So the amount produced is going to be greater than the amount sold, so the ending inventory is going to increase, which is going to make absorption costing greater than...
Absorption is going to be greater than variable, because variable deducts all the fixed costs now and absorption didn't. Absorption took 200 units and the fixed costs associated with them to the next accounting period. Variable is going to deduct them all now. Absorption costing net income will be higher than variable costing net income when inventory increases. Let's do what the book asks us to do. The book asks us to prepare a variable costing income statement. Let's put a good heading on it. A variable costing income statement starts with sales. Do we know sales, class?
Yes.
How much are they? 5.85 million, yes or no? Is it okay to look on the one that we just did and grab that same number and kind of borrow it, steal it? It's okay. From sales, I need to deduct something. If you know the name of what you subtract, would you hold your hand and tell me? Let's go faster. Toby?
Cost of goods sold.
Is incorrect. Is incorrect. I did that on the last one we just did. Isn't it funny that nobody wants to volunteer until you make a mistake? In my peripheral vision, I can see about 30 people with their hands up.
Yeah.
Isn't that funny, Toby? They won't do it themselves, but boy, they'll jump on you when you miss it. Right? Good afternoon, Whit.
Variable cost of goods sold.
Variable cost of goods sold is what I was looking for, Whit. Thank you very much. Alexis, let's time this real quickly, shall we? Start the stopwatch and class. Tell me how to get variable cost of goods sold. Whit!
You're getting inventory?
Good. Is how much in this problem? In the interest of time, I'm going to tell you, Whit, that it's zero. It's okay. I'm glad you brought it up. We needed to bring it up. I would have overlooked it. Your answer was better than me. Zero. To beginning inventory, we need to add something. Help me. Jeff?
Cost of goods manufactured?
Let's start there. All of them?
Just the variables.
Just the variables. Go. You meant that would be... How come Jeff's the only one tinkering on his calculator right now?
3,250,000.
How did you get that?
The 2,800 of variable cost times the 1,300 units produced.
1,500 units were produced, Jeff.
Oh, yeah.
1,500 units produced times 2,800, the cost of one unit variable costing, Jeff, is?
4.2 million.
4.2 million. That's how many units, Jeff?
2,800.
Do we need to add in fixed cost right now? This is a variable costing income statement. We're leaving out the fixed cost. So we're going to deduct this number from this number. We're going to deduct the cost of 1,500 units from the revenue earned from 1,300 units. Jeff?
No.
Why not?
Because that 200 units is too many.
That wouldn't be matching, right?
Yep.
So can we get from where we are right this minute to where we need to be? Or let me rephrase the question. How would we get from where we are right this minute to where we need to be, Jeff?
Find the cost of ending inventory.
Let's do that. Can we reach over on that income statement we already prepared and grab that inventory figure and save some time?
No.
Why not?
Because that's counting fixed costs.
That's got fixed cost in it. We want this ending inventory figure to just be variable cost. So how are we going to get it, Jeff?
200 times 2,800.
200 units in ending inventory at the price, $2,800 each. Jeff is... $560,000. 1,500 units minus 200 units is the cost of 1,300 units. The cost of 1,300 units, Jeff, is...
$1.2 million.
That's not what I...
3,640,000.
3,640,000. Stop the stopwatch, Alexis. How long did that take?
255.
One more time?
255.
255. We spent getting variable cost of goods sold. Let's put a good heading on something. Let's start with sales. Let's pretend we didn't do anything over here, but we started with $5.85 million of revenue. Start the stopwatch. I want to subtract from that variable cost of goods sold. How many units of revenue did I report, class? Help me find 1,300 units of variable cost. 1,300 units at what price per? Aaron? Can I trust you? 2,800 times 1,300 is how much, Aaron?
3.64 million.
Like that? Stop the stopwatch. Alexis?
Well, we got 31 seconds.
Am I tempting anybody into considering doing this in the future? You don't have to show all your work. We want answers. We want right answers. It's all about getting the right answer, presenting it in a way that a user would benefit from it, not necessarily matching your format to some other prescribed format. You can do it lots of ways. Let's finish this one. If you subtracted variable cost of goods sold from sales, you get something called manufacturing margin. I still talk about that. It's not in the book. I need to subtract something from manufacturing margin. If you know what I need to subtract right this minute, would you help me? Toby?
Variable admin expense.
The thing that you need to know about this financial statement is that it deducts everything variable first. You want to subtract variable expenses, Toby. Help me find them.
It's a 70 per unit, so 70 multiplied by
1,300 or 1,500?
1,300.
It's usually per unit sold. So 1,300 times 70, Toby, is
91,000.
The name of this subtotal class, everybody that knows said, this is contribution margin. I need you to know that, at least how to get it today, because next time in class, it's assumed that you know how to get it, and we just talk about using it then. Contribution margin is 91,000 from 2.21 million. I got 2.119 million contribution margin I can use in auto.
That's right.
Fixed costs and expenses need to be subtracted from this. Fixed costs, which we ignored earlier, are, could somebody tell me this number? Everybody in the room should be able to tell me this number. It's in the problem. Read it to me. Fixed costs are?
100,000.
Is not the number I see. Say it to me, Tucker.
1,400,000.
1.4 million are fixed costs. Fixed expenses are how much, Jeff?
Oh, 100,000.
With the emphasis on the, 100,000. Fixed costs and expenses are 1.5 million. Contribution margin minus fixed costs and expenses is net income of 619,000, same as we got a minute ago under absorption costing, or different?
Different.
Same or different?
Different.
I'm going to try to explain why we got those different answers. The rounding part's not going to help me a whole lot. I'm going to see if we can't come up with it and see why. If you look at your two income statements, the answer we just got was 619,000. The answer we got a few minutes ago was 805,667. Did you look back at your notes, if you took notes, and see that that number's true? Is that the number I had? This is a difference of $186,667 that you could find or prove, if you want to look at it that way, in at least two approaches. You could think of it in total, or you could think of it per unit. If we did this in total, it would be the ending inventory valuation that we put on the 200 units in ending inventory that would be the difference. If you looked at your absorption costing income statement, we valued ending inventory at $746,667. Don't take my word for it. Would five of you at least assure me that that number is the number you wrote down?
Yeah.
Yes or no?
Yeah.
On the absorption costing income statement. The one we just did valued them at $2,800 each. That was $560,000, 200 units in ending inventory. That is that $186,667 difference in total. It is ending inventory treated differently. That is the reason for the difference. Now, if you want to think of it per unit, we've still got that information on the screen, on the market board right here. If you think about the absorption costing number, it is 3733. At the very beginning of this exercise, we determined the variable cost per unit to be 2,800. We used that throughout this exercise for variable cost. That difference is these fixed costs of $933.33. It was the 200 units in ending inventory treated differently by these fixed costs per unit. 933 times 200 is 186,667. Proof. That $933 is the calculation we made earlier today at the very beginning of this exercise when we took the 1.4 million and divided by 1,500 units produced. That's fixed cost per unit. It turned into, just do this. I'm sorry for that. It was supposed to be granting you freedom to understand it better and do it in more than one acceptable alternative way. Have a nice day.